Only females are allowed into a male's burrow, but mating between two such aggressive animals is never a gentle affair. The male has to turn her on her back to copulate. Immediately afterwards, the female turns nasty, and the male must make a quick exit, even if that means breaking through the back door. So, just how powerful are the blows of a large mantis shrimp? And how skilled are they at learning and at manipulating objects? These are questions for which Roy Caldwell has been seeking the answers in his laboratory.
In one particular experiment that we've been running, we present the animals with cubes of different colors. These are plastic cubes, which on one face has been placed a piece of glass. And for the animal to extract the food, it must break through the glass. One color of cube will contain a piece of shrimp. And what we're finding, to our surprise, is that these animals are incredibly good at learning which cube has the food, which cube to open. After the animal has selected the appropriate cube, it returns it to its burrow and literally smashes its way through the glass to extract the shrimp.
The glass doesn't harm the stomatopod, and whilst inexperienced animals at first aim strikes anywhere on the cube, they soon become skilled at selecting the side with the thin glass and breaking it open. Stomatopods have 8 pairs of appendages. The last 3 pairs are walking legs, but amongst the first 5 are long, finger-like hooks used to grasp objects. It's these hooks which reach in and remove food from the cube.
One of our plastic cubes is very much like a snail. There's a thick shell which has to be broken to get through to the meat. When we gave the animal different size members of one particular species, we found that with small snails, it maybe took 4 or 5 strikes to break open the prey. As the prey became larger, the number of strikes that it took to break it open became considerably greater, so that for a fairly large snail, the animal may have to work for an hour or more, delivering up to 500 strikes before it was able to extract the meat.
These pugists will hit out at anything, so to measure the precise force of the knockout punch, Roy rigged up an oscilloscope wired to a rubber punch bag. When the bag is punched, the impact is transferred via a force transducer to the oscilloscope screen. The results were astonishing. The power of the strike is just a little less than that of a .22 caliber bullet. With this sort of firepower around, it's no surprise most crabs like to keep their heads down. Tiptoeing past a burrow may be another way of keeping out of trouble. But even burrowing out of sight will not protect a crab from a hungry mantis shrimp. Both clubs can break a crab apart, destroying its nervous system and killing it instantly. The evolution of more formidable weapons enables stomatopods to consume larger prey. That, however, also meant that individuals were able to fight one another more effectively, and therefore they had to develop heavier armor at the same time. Now, few creatures in their world can compete with them. Even the reef's armor-plated battle tank, the slipper lobster, meets its match. It can't outgun a mantis shrimp. A duel like this is high noon for the lobster and any other challenger to the undefeated title holder, the fastest claw on the reef.